They say if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. And one of the main reasons everyone says this about New York is because it is one of the most expensive cities to live in the entire world. With the average rent in Manhattan recently crossing over $5,000 per month, you might be asking yourself, could I ever live somewhere in New York with those prices? Well, hi, my name is Adam, and I'm currently living in a tiny 200 square foot apartment in Manhattan that costs a little over $1,600 per month. Situated right on the edge of Lenox Hill, which is on the southern end of the Upper East Side, this area is known for its luxurious brownstones and has more of a suburban feel to it. Walking around, you'll find lots of families, elderly people, and high-end boutiques. And on top of that, you're only a short walk away from Central Park in Midtown Manhattan. All right, let's get on with this tour so I can show you how I was able to make this tiny studio work for me. Okay, so right when you enter my apartment, we have the closet here on the right, which as you can see, I use just about every square inch of. I know it looks really small, but it's pretty deep, and there is a second rack behind this one here in front. And then right across from my closet, we have the bathroom here on the left, which I know it's also really small, but honestly, I'm just glad that everything works and that you're able to sit on the toilet properly, because in a lot of cheaper New York apartments, that's not the case. If you take just about two steps forward from the main entrance, we're now in the kitchen, which has all the essentials. There's a stove, an oven, a sink, and about a foot of counter space. Okay, maybe not all the essentials because I don't have a dishwasher here, so I clean everything by hand. There's also a pretty good amount of cabinet space for all my dishes here, and I'd say I also have a pretty decent sized fridge. All right, so now we're moving on to the main living area of this apartment, which is where I spend a majority of my time, whether it's eating, sleeping, getting work done, studying, or even just relaxing for a bit. So when you live in a studio, you kind of have to section off the room for different purposes. So like over here, this is the bedroom area. And then over here, this is like what I would consider to be the living room. And then over here at my desk, this is basically like an office mixed with a dining room. So with my bed over here, I got it from IKEA, and I chose this one specifically because I wanted to be able to put stuff underneath for storage, and then also I wanted it to have a simple design so that it could be easily taken apart when I have to move. This couch that I'm sitting on is also from IKEA, and I decided to get it in a dark gray color so that if I ever spilled anything, hopefully it wouldn't show up. Luckily, it hasn't happened yet, so I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Okay, so with my desk, I chose something very minimal, and one thing about this area is I like to keep it very empty. So besides my computer, there's really nothing else here, and that's because sometimes I use this area to do work, and other times I'm here eating, and I like to be able to switch quickly between the two. Right next to my desk, I have this lamp with all these shelves built in, so this is where I keep all of my books. And what I really like about this is that not only is it a nice decoration, but it's also very practical, and that's what you constantly have to be thinking about when you have an apartment as small as mine. And speaking of decorations, over here I have this painting that I got from an artist in Central Park. I have a guitar hung up on this wall, and then over here I have all these 4x4 album covers from a bunch of different artists that I listen to. Also, when you're thinking about how you're gonna decorate a studio, it's really important to consider how one part of the room is gonna flow into the next. So let me show you what I mean. Right here, I have my refrigerator, and that kind of marks the end of the kitchen. And then down here, I've got my trash can. Oh, and side note, if you're living in a studio, please get a nice trash can with a lid so it doesn't stink up the entire room. Okay, so what I was saying is you need there to be kind of like a nice transition from one section of the room to the next. And so what I did for this area is I got this fake bamboo tree, which honestly is one of my favorite parts of this apartment. I think it does a great job of covering up the trash can and then also creating some nice separation between the kitchen and the living room. Okay, and then this over here feels a little bit unnecessary to talk about, but this is my AC, and there's nothing special about it, but the reason that I wanted to mention this is because you don't realize how important it is unless you don't have one, which was the case for me when I first moved here. So for my first 3 or 4 days that I was in this apartment, I did not have an air conditioner, and this was in the middle of summer. So please, if you're moving into an apartment without an AC, especially during summer, do yourself a favor and go buy one before you do anything else.
All right, so that's what the inside of this studio looks like. But also in my building, we're able to go out onto the fire escape. So I'm gonna show you what that looks like real quick. Okay, it's super noisy out here, but this is just a really nice place to be able to come out, relax, do some people watching, and sometimes if you're lucky, even hang out with your neighbors for a bit. All right, so I think the only thing left that I have to show you is what you can expect from a building similar to the one that I'm in. So now I'm gonna take you down to the lobby and then to the laundry room. All right, so this is the lobby and there's nothing special here. We don't have a doorman or anything because this ain't like a luxury apartment. But over here, you have the entrance. Over here, this is where we get our mail. And then behind me over there is the elevator. All right, so now it's time for what's probably the worst part of this apartment tour, the laundry room. And the reason I say this is the worst part is because it's also our trash room. I will say it's super nice to have a washer and dryer in building, but oftentimes when I come down here, I am greeted by a little Remy or a meal. And honestly, it's something that I've gotten used to over time. I would say I'm just glad that none of the rats down here have ever tried to attack me. So I can't really complain. All right, so there you have it. That's what $1,600 a month gets you on the Upper East Side of Manhattan. Or not. See, that's what it got me. But by the time you're watching this video, there isn't gonna be a single deal as good as the one that I have right now. Unfortunately, rent in New York City has gone up dramatically. Back when I got this place about a year ago, apartments were going for super cheap because of COVID, but now it's a completely different story. Now, this tiny 200 square foot apartment is going on the market for $2,600 a month. That means that the price will be going up by almost $1,000 every single month. Honestly, I still can't believe how insane that is. Also, I did some digging on StreetEasy to see what other kind of deals I could find, and you can't really find anything for like under $2,000 in Manhattan right now. So, does this mean that everyone's dreams of living in New York are completely ruined? Well, no. See, there's a couple other things you could do. One, you could go and find roommates, which would make the price of an apartment much cheaper, or you could consider moving out to one of the other boroughs like Brooklyn or Queens. There's lots of amazing communities in these areas, and the only real downside is that you're gonna have a longer commute, but you'll be able to find a much more affordable apartment out there. And the last thing I want to talk about in this video are some of the requirements that you'll need if you want to get an apartment here in New York City. Everyone in New York always jokes that you basically have to give an arm and a leg to get an apartment here in New York, but I'm gonna show you what some of the actual requirements are. So every landlord and broker is different, but here are some of the things that you'll typically need. I'm gonna have to read this out. First, you're gonna need an employment verification letter, your three most recent pay stubs and bank statements, your federal tax returns, two different forms of ID, a copy of your social security card, and sometimes even a recommendation letter from a previous landlord. And on top of all of that, your annual income needs to be 40 times the monthly rent. And if you don't meet that requirement, you need to find a guarantor who makes 80 times the monthly rent. So yeah, it's insanely difficult to live here in New York, but I still think it's an amazing place to be. Overall, New York just isn't the most comfortable city to be in general, but I think that the reason people come here is because they have a dream that they want to turn into reality, and they know that this is where they can make it happen. And that's what makes it so special here. It's not about the living space or the nice quiet neighborhood that you live in. It's about the energy and the spirit that you're able to feed off of from other people just like you who come from all around the world to live out their dreams.